Hi everyone, this is Divyarati from Venkateshwar School. In today's session for class 12, Biology, Chapter 8, Human Health and Diseases, we are going to study about immunity or disease resistance.
Immunity or disease resistance. Immunity can be defined as the ability of an organism to recognize the foreign material that enter the body and to mobilize the cells and cell products to speedily remove that foreign material. Now, the immunity is of two types: innate or inborn immunity, acquired or adaptive immunity. Now, let's first discuss about innate or non-specific immunity. It is present from the birth and is inherited from parents. It is non-specific. It is accomplished by providing different types of barriers. First is physical barriers. These barriers do not allow pathogens and foreign agents to enter the body. Example, skin, mucous membranes of digestive, respiratory, and urogenital tracts, they trap the microorganisms. Second is physiological barriers. Sweat, tear, acid in stomach, and saliva prevent microbacterial growth. Cellular barriers. WBC, that is the white blood cells, polymorphonuclear leukocytes, and monocytes, natural killer lymphocytes, and macrophages, phagocytose, and destroy microbes. Now, what is phagocytosis? Phagocytosis is the process of engulfing and destroying the microbe or the pathogen by some cells. The cells that involve in phagocytosis are called phagocytes. The neutrophils and the monocytes, they are a type of WBC, are important phagocytic cells. Now, the natural killer cells, they are also called NK cells. These are non-phagocytic large lymphocytes. And they mainly recognize the viral infected cells or the tumor cells. It destroys them by secreting cytolysin, hence they are called killer cells. Now, the interferons, they are known as cytokine barriers. Interferons are produced by virus infected cells, protect non-infected cells from further viral infections. Inflammatory response. It is a localized response to the injury, infection, or irritation. The symptoms are getting redness, swelling, pain, increasing body temperature, etc. Now, the next type of immunity is acquired or adaptive or specific immunity. It is not present from the birth and develops during an individual's lifetime. It is pathogenic specific. It has the ability to distinguish diverse types of foreign molecules or antigens. When the immune system encounters a pathogen for the first time, a primary response is produced, which is of low intensity. The memory of this encounter with the same pathogen is also formed on subsequent encounter with the same pathogen, a secondary or anamnestic response is produced, which is of very high intensity. Now, the immune responses are produced by two types of lymphocytes. One is B lymphocytes or B cells, and the other is called T lymphocytes or T cells. Now, let's study about T lymphocytes first. T lymphocytes, they help the B cells to produce antibodies. They are undifferentiated lymphocytes which originate from the stem cells of bone marrow, and some may migrate to thymus gland, and they are differentiated into T lymphocytes. Now, the B lymphocytes, they produce an army of proteins called antibodies in the blood in response to pathogens. They are undifferentiated lymphocytes, originate from the stem cells of bone marrow, but they migrate to bursa, equivalent and differentiated into B lymphocytes. Bursa is nothing, they are lymphoid tissue in bone marrow. Now, the antigen. Antigen is defined as any foreign substance that enters in our body and stimulates our immune response is called antigen. Now, this antigen has two main properties. Antigenicity, that is the ability of an antigen to generate a specific immune response to produce antibodies. And second is immunogenicity. It is the ability of the antigen to react with specific antibodies. Biochemically, antigens are protein, large polysaccharides, lipids, fatty acids, or nucleic acids. Sometimes entire pathogen act as antigen. Thank you.